Welcome to another Teardown video. This time it's again one of those Linak table power controllers. And look at this one. IP66. That is amazing. I didn't know that. So it's even written here on the top, IP66. And look at that baby. They went all the way with this water protection. So IP66 means it will handle powerful jets of water. Not just a little bit of rain, but powerful jets. I don't know how to pull out this mains connector. I think it's... Is it just pull? So those are... Okay, it looks like just push in. I don't have any of the other connectors, but it definitely looks like there will be O-rings and everything, including some lubrication even. So it's super watertight. Let's have a look what is inside this watertight thingy. Whew, that was tough. I finally got this power connector out. Whew, with this O-ring and everything, I needed to pull like 50 kilos to pull this out. Oh my god, that was insane. But out it came. Oh, by the way, if you're doing all sorts of 3D printing designs and stuff like that, save those screws because they're super useful for your homebrew plastic projects. Super good stuff. So let's... What? We got batteries as well, so this battery backed up. What? I didn't expect that. And there's... Oh, that's a connector. Now that is pretty funny. Wow, we got batteries. So this looks a lot like some kind of a hospital thing or surgery room or something like that. Because why would you need batteries? Because you must... There must always be a way out. So this is probably for a hospital chair, bed, something like that. With, battery backed up as well. Wow, cool. I didn't expect that at all. So, oh, we need some more. More screws. Hang on a second. Wow, it is completely different build. Much more sexy design compared to the usual. I mean, the usual build quality is really, really high and cool and everything is nice, but... Come. And again, those are very useful for all sorts of... homebrew stuff. 21 and 28 volts, 3 amps. So yeah, it's definitely reusable. All you have to do is just pull up. It is that easy. I mean, they designed this to be recycled really, really fast and easy. So all you have to do is just pull everything out. Just... Where's the screw? Ah, okay. All we have to do is just push here a little clicky clicky. I need 2 fingers to do that. So it was only those 4 little clicks and then the board is out. Super easy. I guess there's a little beeper. I wonder what that is doing. But I don't see any microcontroller or anything, just some gates and op amp, probably just some a current sense, because see, we've got a current sense resistor, so we'll just run the motors, 4 motors, back and forward, relays, and then it will just turn off when you have reached the maximum or minimum whatever direction. And it's probably a fast and a slow, so that will be a relay for that. That is because we have two windings on the transformator. But it's just super simple with some relays and some buttons to do that. And it's a single layer board. And there's another funny thing about their cutting out here. It's not because they care about height, because we got plenty of height. No, it's because you just put in those big powerful components and now they're not gonna roll off the board, because now they're stuck into the hole, so they're fixed, and then it's all manufacturable by the normal kind of SMD process. That is how you do it, as fast as possible and as easy and as cheap as possible. Genius, I love it. Some really beautiful relays as well. So yeah, that is kind of what there was in this thing. It's probably also a little battery charger system. I wonder if there's any voltage on the batteries. I'm gonna measure that. Nope. Point six. And 0.7, so they're completely dead. That is how it is with lead acid. But it's a really sexy little size. Just too bad you can't use them for anything